Hallo en welkom to our channel. Today we'll cook festive poppy seed cake. It's a beautiful fluffy sponge cake full of poppy seeds with gentle cream inside and incredible chocolate glaze on top. List of ingredients you will find in the description below this video or on our website rednumber1.com. Let's get started. Preheat your oven up to 180 degrees Celsius or 356 degrees Fahrenheit. In a medium bowl, mix together flour, poppy seeds, baking powder and vanilla sugar. Then separate egg whites from yolks. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments below this video. Whisk yolks with most of the sugar until white and smooth cream. Then whisk whites with rest of the sugar until soft peaks. In 3 steps, add whipped whites to the yolks by gently fold in the same direction bottom up. Now gradually add dry mixture. Carefully mix each portion. Let me know in the comments below what kind of cake you want to see in my next video. Maybe honey cake? After, thin trickle, pour melted butter. Lightly cool down butter before adding. Mix gently until well combined and smooth, but not too long. Prepare 8 inches diameter springform pan. Cover bottom of a springform tin with baking sheet. And this time we don't need butter at the tin walls. Place butter into a baking tin. Carefully arrange with the spatula and bake 40-45 minutes until evenly golden. Check redness with the dry wooden skewer. Let your poppy seed sponge cake cool down in the springform tin. After, cut on 3-4 layers. First, make the marks with knife by making no deep cuttings. Then you might use a clean fishing line like me or unflavored dental floss. Align fishing line around the cake following the marks from knife. When the fishing line is fully wrapped around the cake, cross the end of the line and hold each end and each hand. Pull the chain out and away from the cake, so the fishing line cuts through the cake as the circle tightens. Slightly move the fishing line from side to side to help the cutting process. Voila, first layer is ready. Repeat with the remaining ones. I have 3 layers of cake today. And what about yours? Let me know in the comments down this video. Carefully flip the last layer of your cake and remove the baking sheet. Now time to cook our cream. List of ingredients below this video or on our website rednumber1.com. Cut vanilla pot lengthwise and scrape the seeds to the stew pot with heavy cream. Whisk yolks with sugar until white and smooth cream. Place stew pot with heavy cream on a medium-high heat. Bring to the boil and remove from the heat. Carefully, by thin trickle, constantly stirring, pour hot heavy cream to the boil with whipped yolks. Then pour mixture back into a stew pot. Put stew pot with cream on a low heat and cook until thick. Constantly stirring with silicone or wooden spatula so cream doesn't stick to the bottom. Cream is ready. Time to put all layers of our cake together. Put the down layer of cake back to the springform pan and pour with the half of the hot cream or use the third part of cream if you got the 4 layers. Repeat with the other one. The top layer leave free of cream for chocolate glaze. Let cake cool down at the room temperature for 2-3 hours and then place into the fridge for overnight. Cake is chilled and ready for decoration. Carefully open and remove springform pan. Actually, you may eat this cake as it is, but for holidays I prefer to decorate it. Move our cake to the rack with deep plate or tray below. Align the cream on the edges of cake with spatula. For chocolate glaze we will need 75 grams on 2.5 ounces butter, 200 grams or 7 ounces dark chocolate and 1 tablespoon brandy. Chocolate glaze have to be cooked on a bain-marie. Stew pot where you're going to melt chocolate have to be bigger than pot with the hot water, so boiling water don't touch it bottom. Also, don't let any water goes inside the stew pot with chocolate, it will destroy the color and view of glaze. Put chocolate and butter into a stew pan and stir until melted. Subscribe and you never miss our new delicious video recipes. Pour brandy and combine well. When surface of glaze becomes smooth and silky, it's ready. Remove stew pot from water bath and pour over your cake with this beautiful satin glaze. For more delicious recipes, go to our website rednumber1.com. Use spatula to cover all the edges evenly. And now your time to be creative. This time, I'm decorating my cake with the almond petals and white chocolate glaze. So Beautiful. What do you think? And it's time to try our magic poppy seed cake. Bon appétit! Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this recipe, give us big thumbs up and subscribe.